So good morning, everyone.
Good morning, sir.
So thank you, Deepa, for completing the initial formalities of surveying about the startup awareness. So first, let me cover about what TAI is and what we are doing currently. So TAI is a global organization. We are a 25-year-old organization present across 18 countries. It was started by people like Vinod Khosla, Kanwal Reki in the US, and then it started their chapters in India by some of the early adopters were Mr. Nandan Nilekani, Srini Raju, and then J.S. Chaudhary Garu, and all the people who started chapters in India. So the early chapters in India were Delhi, Mumbai, and all, which were there for the last 20-25 years. And TAI Amaravati chapter is a new one. We'll be completing our first anniversary in another 15 days time. So what we have been doing in AP is, our focus has been on three things. At the policy level, we work with the government closely. In fact, we've given the framework on how to utilize the 100 crore startup fund that the state government has announced. And we have an angel network which invests in the startups. We invest up to 1 crore in each startup. And the government has come forward to match whatever investment we do in these startups. And then, as usual, TAI has been formed to support startups. So whatever activities that we do are majorly classified as education-related activities, which could be workshops on how to run a business, or it could be as complex as how to value your business, how to raise funds, and anything related to running a startup. Then we have a huge network of successful entrepreneurs or senior executives who would provide mentorship to the next generation entrepreneurs and the startups and help them grow. And we have incubation and funding support. As I've told you, that we have an angel network which invests in these startups. So worldwide, TAI has always been focusing on majorly on startups, and then they've been consulting the governments in terms of the policy. But TAI Amaravati has also included focus on education institutions, because we've seen that most of the innovation and the startup activities are coming from the universities, and especially around Vijayawada, we have many universities, and we see that most of these universities are doing great in bringing out the startups. So we started focusing on educational institutions. We've been reaching out to the colleges. We've done an event where we invited some of the successful incubators across the country from education institution setup to sensitize the college management and the faculty about student entrepreneurship. So this happened last July, and then since then we've been working with some of the education institutions in adopting their incubation centers and help mentoring their startups. And then coming to the other activities that we've been doing, our next activity in Vijayawada, we are focusing on women entrepreneurship. We've invited some entrepreneurs, women entrepreneurs, to come down to Vijayawada and talk about the journey and inspire women. This is happening on 8th Jan, next Tuesday, in Andhra Loyola Engineering College. So whoever are interested to listen to the entrepreneurs, you're always welcome. And soon we are also signing up an MOU with one of the real estate company, which is building a core startup infrastructure in Amaravati region. We've been working with them. So we'll be formally signing an MOU, and we'll be supporting the ecosystem. So of late, we've been also working with other ecosystem partners who are working in a similar space. So you do have enough opportunities, and you're lucky enough that you are from Vijayawada, and Vijayawada as a place has that advantage, since it has always been enterprising, because in most of the other places you see the generation in the 80s being into government jobs and all, but Vijayawada has always been enterprising, and there is a lot of business activity happening here. So you do have many people around you who can be your inspirational role models. So you are at an advantage now to start up. So you there are enough opportunities in Amravati. So make use of these, and whenever you need any help, you can always reach out to anyone in the ecosystem. So don't just neglect thinking that you are still young or it doesn't happen at the student stage. So because most of the successful companies like Google and all have come from the student level, and those have been started from universities. So don't just neglect any of the ideas that you get. You can always work on them, and feel free to discuss with your friends, and because that's when you get to refine your ideas well. So discuss and work, take your ideas seriously. Thank you.